Hello everyone. Today, we're working on my 1984 Porsche 944. As you may have recalled, we left this car off with some idling issues. In this video, we'll be getting the car from this, to this, and then finally, to this. While I get the fuel rail depressurized and removed, let me talk through some of the things we ended up replacing or maintaining and the thought process behind them. First off was the vacuum lines. Secondly, we cleaned the fuel injectors. We also replaced the fuel regulator, the fuel damper, although not with an OEM solution, and the fuel DME relay. The number one issue that was popping up online as a culprit to the poor idle was primarily check your vacuum lines. It's pretty straightforward on any car and was on my list of things to do anyways. I don't have footage of that in this video, but you'll see later on that the vacuum lines do get replaced. The fuel regulator and damper were on my list to replace, as those were common culprits of rich conditions on this vehicle as well once they've failed. Additionally, I found fuel in the vacuum lines, which is a telltale sign for either the fuel regulator or the damper failing. I opted initially for the simpler route of replacing the regulator, as the damper is a whole different story. However, the regulator didn't resolve my issue. When it came to the fuel damper, it was tough to justify purchasing an OEM part. The part is discontinued, so it has prices in the realm of $300 to $600, and I wasn't going to scout a used part when these are notorious for failing. Sifting through some forums and videos, I saw mention of radium fuel dampers. It wasn't really anything detailed on how to get it working, but I did know that I didn't want to have to invest into a new fuel rail, nor modify my existing one. That means whatever solution I went with had to be pretty much plug and play. I'm in no way affiliated with the products I'm mentioning today, so take that in mind when listening in. Radium Auto has some detailed information on how to determine which fuel damper works best for your application with some real-world scenarios. Based on the values they provided and the fact that this is a 1984 Porsche 944, I went with the 8AN FPD-R option, as the base pressure requirement fell into the 40 to 70 PSI range. In order to get it to work, I had to leverage a few different adapters to make sure that everything fit as expected, which is covered later in this video. I haven't sorted out a mounting solution to prevent vibration for this damper yet, but I'll likely have to fabricate something to mount it to the existing fuel damper location. Lastly, although the fuel damper solved the primary issue of the poor idle, there was still an odd issue where the idle would bounce up and down after a warm start. This appeared to be the result of the fuel DME relay. When I swapped out the existing URO unit for an alternate brand, Strebel, the warm start idle issue resolved itself. With that said, let's go ahead and get into the repair. I'll be chiming back in when we get to the fuel damper installation. Thank you. Now for the part most of you are probably waiting for. I'll freeze frame here in a second to break down the adapters I ended up using. Coming from the fuel line, I used an 8AN flare to 16mm by 1.5, but the 16mm side needed to be sloped inwards as a female to line up with the existing fuel line. Then I added an 8AN to 8AN swivel adapter to clear the mounting bracket to prevent the damper from hitting the fuel rail. The last adapter before the fuel damper is an 8AN to 8AN, but the 8AN fitting to the swivel also needed to be sloped to ensure a flush seal against the fitting. The damper definitely looks out of place and still needs a mounting solution, but after this and the DME relay that was replaced, you'll see here in a moment that the 944 runs much better now. If you've made it this far, you're about to hear the car idle nice and smooth. Additionally, I just wanted to say thank you for everyone who takes the time to watch these videos. It means a lot to me. I hope this was helpful, and as always, don't forget to like and subscribe if it was. Thank you.